you catch a break and you want to help.
Yeah.
You know, you want to help. There's nothing worse than helping somebody when you know you feel like you've been fucked.
Oh, I've been fucked.
And you get fucked.
I have.
You, and it hurts you feeling, you know. For years, like I said, when I was a kid, I would do walk-a-thons, the American Heart Association, and I always tried to do something as a kid. My mother always, you know, I always sold boosters or candies. You know, I always did something. Sometimes I took a 10. I'm not going to lie to you for an album, but you know what I'm saying? 90% of the money went sometime. You know, I was a kid. I was a stupid kid, but I always believed in giving back. Years ago, I went to work for an administration, and I found out they were nonprofit. And for every $10 you give, the kid with the missing eye gets 58 cents. And meanwhile, the two dudes out front are driving 7 Series BMWs.
Yeah, yeah.
It does something to a guy like me.
Yeah, I used to volunteer for a big nonprofit that I won't name.
No,
but I found out after working many months and helping them, volunteering, that a dime, if everybody gave a dollar, a dime went to it. And the other was two fat cats living up in a big mansion. And I was like, you know, I was disgusted.
Embarrassed.
Disgusted.
Listen, I don't mind you robbing me. Bring a fucking gun, bitch.
Yeah.
Bring a fucking gun, and I'll give you what I got.
Yeah.
But if you're going to rob me that way and I find out, and now what does it do? It takes a guy like me that has a heart, and it deters me from helping people that really need it. You know, I won't give to a homeless fucking organization, but I'll give that guy at the 7-Eleven a 20.
Yeah.
I'll give it right to the fucking guy's hand. And every time I see this dude, I give him a 20, a 10, 3, whatever the fuck is in your wallet, you give the poor guy. That I believe in. But I don't want to be a part of something where, you know, you're in fucking Belize, hanging out with the Stones, and we're all donating to you, you know, whatever.
That's why we started our own.
I love this. I didn't know anything about this.
When he passed away, people were saying, I want to give money to charity. What do we do? What do we do? And after my experience I had, I said, you know what? I don't know. So Ronnie's doctor and I formed the Ronnie James Dio Stand Up and Shout Cancer Fund. And 14 people that were friends of Ronnie's that have been around forever all joined in. We 100% of the money goes to the charity. We have no administration costs. We meet once a month. We don't pay for anywhere to go. We don't have any office. We use my office or something else. No money goes out anywhere except to where we need to put it. And that is not in some fat cat's pocket.
When I get out of here today, Wendy, I'm going to have my wife make a donation since I can't go next
That's very, very kind.
Thursday from very me kind. And Lee in the very church kind. Of what's happening now.
Yeah,
because you just made my dick hard by telling me these things that, you know, like I said, nobody wants to feel shitty about donating.
No.
You know, I give away shirts every month. I do a clean out and I go up the corner up here and give away clothes to homeless. I go with bags, you know. People send t-shirts. So every time somebody sends 3 t-shirts, I'll take one of their t-shirts and let's put on a homeless person, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
I try to help as much as I can, but like anybody else in America, we all work very hard for our money. And before you give it to somebody who's on
their Facebook page. You want to make sure it's going to where it's supposed to go.
And they're on a fucking cruise.
Yeah. Oh, God.
I want it
to
go where it's supposed to go. Yeah. I mean, I have that right, you know.
Yeah.
We had on the kid from the Celtics here.
Chris Herring.
Chris Herring. He has a foundation, rehabs, the whole thing. We donate to him once a year, you know. I'm looking for places. But again, I don't do it for a tax write. I don't give a fuck about a tax write-off. I do it because I want to feel good about myself. I want to help, you know.
We've done a lot of things, like we've paid for different people's funerals, things like that, that we don't really publicize.
You don't need to.
You know, the different things that were medical costs, different things that if somebody needs, I mean, that's not what our charity does, but on occasions when somebody needs the help, we help.
You're a class act, Wendy.
Making a little place in heaven for me, making sure I don't go down there.
Well, you never know. You never know. They might put you in purgatory just to chill for a couple of weeks with Coach Ann. And you got to do jumping jacks with Coach Ann every fucking day or something. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, God.
My God. This has been just weird not meeting you and knowing you're in the circle. And Like everybody fucking knows you.
Of course. They better.
How the fuck do you know everybody like this? This is just
because I pull them all in to do stuff with us, and they do. You know, they always put down heavy metal, dirty piggy, dirty people, whatever. You know what? Heavy metal people, rock people are the most amazing people that give their time and their talent to me all the time for this cause, and they're amazing.